Hey, happy Sunday. I'm Chelsea from thestudentarchitect.com, where I create software tutorials and provide a variety of resources for architects and architecture students. If you're looking to build better models faster, consider checking out my Foundations of Revit course over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes. So today we're going to talk about different ways that you can add setback lines into your Revit models. So if I double click to activate this existing site plan, you'll see that I have a property line in here as well as my setback lines. And when I hover over one of these setback lines, you can see that I'm using a detail line. And if I click on the line, you'll see that I can change it to whatever I want. And you'll see if I scroll down, I can actually choose a setback line so that it has its own specific line type. The problem though with using detail lines is that if I go to my proposed plan, you're not going to see those setback lines on this plan, and that's because it's a 2D element that only exists in that drawing. I could select all of those setback lines, hit Control C on my keyboard, double click to activate the proposed plan and paste in place. But that's really an imperfect process, and it's not hard to imagine a variety of scenarios that could lead to issues down the line as you're working on your project. So while this is one way that you could add in your setback lines, it's definitely not my preferred method. So there is another way that you could do that. You could add in a property line if you need to figure out the area of your setbacks. One easy way that you could do that is to use a property line. So I could either click on the property line I have here and hit CS on the keyboard to create similar, or I could use the keyboard shortcut PL and I could create by sketching. Then I can use the rectangular tool here and just sketch over the ones that I already have. Hit OK. And now if I click on this setback property line, you can see that it's telling you what the area of that space is, which could be useful for a variety of reasons. The problem with this method, though, is that there's no way to change the line type of the property lines, at least no way that I know of. So if you do know how to change the property line type, please let me know. That would be very useful to know. But since there's no way to change that, if I go to the proposed plan, you'll see that it looks like we have two property lines here, which could be confusing. So something that you can do on an individual basis on every single view is you could change the graphics by going to Override Graphics by Element, and you could change the line pattern to a setback line. So we'll just put in a dashed line here. But you'll see that that needs to happen on every single drawing. So if I expand this out a little bit so we can actually see that line type, you'll see that that change has not been reflected in any other view. So now we'll go on to my favorite way to add in setback lines. So let's delete this property line. So if you don't need these setback lines to be able to provide you areas or square footages, then what you could use are model lines. So actually what we can do is I can just select these detail lines that we already have. Then I can go up to the Modify tab and click Convert Lines. And that will convert those detail lines into model lines. And I know that they're model lines because if I hover over a line, you'll see it says lines, model lines. And you also know because if you click on a line and you look in the properties panel, you can actually set phasing to these lines as well. So that's a couple of different ways to know which line type you're working with. So now if I go over to my proposed plan, you'll see that those setback lines are still drawn in here. You'll see that the line type has changed a little bit, and that's because that has something to do with the phasing filter that I have on. So if I change that from existing and new to show complete, then you'll see the graphics change, and then those are shown graphically the way that I would want them to be shown. So really the benefit of using model lines is that the line type is correct. You can change it to whatever you want it to be, and you also don't have to keep copying it into every single view that you want those setback lines to show up in. If I go to a 3D view, you can even see the lines there as well. So that could be really helpful for working in a 3D view to make sure that your building is not overstepping, or you can see where things do overstep the setback lines. And it just makes it a little bit easier to work on your project so you don't have to keep flipping back and forth between different views. If you ever did need to figure out what the area of a specific space is, you could always create an area plan for that. And that's something that we can cover in another video. So I really hope that you found this video helpful. And if you did, please hit that like button. And if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe. It really helps out my channel and it lets YouTube know that you like videos like this and they'll show you more of them. I hope you have a great day and I'll see you next Sunday.